Rhea and Bodie. And I'm wife of late... Oh, let me do it again, because I'll do... I'm wife to the late Tom Parker. I met Tom when I was 19, before he joined the boy band that is The Wanted. We got married in 2018. We had a beautiful family, and life was great. But sadly, in August 2020, Tom got diagnosed with a brain tumour. And 18 months later, we lost Tom. I am so lucky to have the amazing support of all my friends and family. Who is everyone in my family? So, there's my mum, Diane. She's a total babe.
It is like being down at the zoo.
My stepdad, Johnny.
Yes, no problem.
My auntie, Julie.
Oh, my God, I miss you.
Then we've got Kelsey and Dean, who are my best friends, and their sons, Albie. And then, who else we've got? We've got Dolly, my dog. I just think we've got such a negative view on death and grief as a nation. So I just want to show people what I'm going through and what I'm living. And you know what? They watched our journey with cancer. Why not watch my journey with grief? Yeah, what are you going to have on your toast anyway? Are you having peanut butter? What are you having, Bo?
Marmite.
I think it feels real to me every day that Tom's gone. I always get asked that question. Do you know what it is? People say, oh, it'll be after the funeral, it will hit her. No, it hit me when he died. Like, as soon as I came back here and he wasn't here, it hit me. Every morning I wake up, he's not laid beside me. Like, there's not a day that I go, wake up or go to bed and I don't think about him because he's not there, he's not with me. He's not downstairs making breakfast with the kids. He's not playing with them outside in the garden. He's not annoying me, asking me some annoying questions. Like, he's just not here now. It would have been Tom's 34th birthday this week, and I didn't want to sit around and be sad. So I've decided to put on a 5K walk and a family fun day, and I'm raising as much money as I can for cancer treatments. Tom wasn't a massive, massive, like, it's my birthday, we all need to celebrate, but I love to celebrate birthdays. The thing is, planning birthdays now is going to just look so different to me. I just got to keep myself as busy as possible, really. I've got an interview with Five Live this morning to help me promote the walk.
Wow, I've gone crazy with that highlighter. Now, Five Live are sending a new link. What, they can even ask me? Right, shall I get my computers and see? I think they're upstairs.
Oh, so here you go. I've got his laptop here. And this is the frustrating thing because, like, he would sort this out for me. If I had interviews or anything, or when I did YouTube, he'd massively help me out because he understood it. How do you get in? I'm in. I couldn't get in last time. Oh, look. This is, look, classic Tom. Just got it all open. Just got some music there that he's wrote. I mean, he's got so many songs on here. His voice was like unreal. I think this is him singing. Let's see.
Girl, wake up.
caught up on the bathroom floor. It is, Tom. I'm playing hard, working out for nothing all week. How clever is he, though, that he produced all of this music? Like, I can't even listen to the Wanted songs. I can't do it. And the kids want to play Glad You Came all the time. I'm like, no, Glad You Came's banned.
Tom was the most amazing singer, and I used to just love listening to him. I find it so hard now when I actually find his music. He was just such a talented, talented man, and he would sit in his studio for hours on end just playing the same bit of music, like the same 8 bars on repeat, and it used to drive me absolutely crazy. But you know what? I would give anything to just listen to him up in that studio one last time.
This is Tom's space. We've got about 25 different laptops and computers. I don't even know where the computers are. This is his organised wire drawer.
All right.
Is this an exclusive we're getting?
Yeah.
Tell everyone about your studio.
This is my studio. I was away so much during the Wanted. I decided that I just want to be so close to my girlfriend, fiance.
Yeah, but it's not good for me, is it?
Yeah,
so I just can't cope with it. Because normally it's about 4 bars. Is that the right thing?
What do you mean?
4 bars. Well, you just repeat it over and over and over.
That's what you have to do.
Hey, but it's boring.
But then it makes me laugh as well when I do think about, like, him. And I look at that screen and I'm like, only he would have a smashed Mac screen. Like, that would annoy anyone else, but not Tom. He's like, yeah, just keep it like that. And it is, what do you do with all this stuff? I mean, I am no music producer, so I don't actually need this stuff, but I don't think I can bring myself to throw it away. And, like, even that picture, I'm like, I can't have any more pictures downstairs of him. Like, I come and look at him before bed. I'll be like, night. This sad one, isn't it? It is just sad, though. It is. And that's the thing that, like, that's why I'd like, sometimes I even just shut the door in this room, because I can't look at it. Now Tom's gone, what I really want to do is help raise as much money as I possibly can for brain cancer. So doing interviews like this helps me have that platform to help, you know, promote and push, you know, the walk that I'm doing, and just push the charities out there that I'm working with, because I need to make a difference. It's sort of, the legacy now lives on through me, that I need to make a change. Do you know what's so funny is, before I do these interviews, I feel like I just have to get, like, all my craziness out. Because I just feel like, because it's going to be live, I could just say something really bad. Be like, right, what are you going to ask me? It's like, now it's going to be the, how are you? And then if I say, oh, I'm actually okay today, it's like, is that the right thing to say? Well, actually, I've had a little cry this morning. And then I looked at all Tom's studio stuff and I cried. Like, they'd be like, what's wrong with her? Okay, right, here we go.
Okay, so it's 7 minutes past 11. And, you know, it's only been 4 months since Tom Parker died.
Nearly a year and a half after he was diagnosed with an inoperable brain tumour.
Seems just so recently.
This weekend would have been the Wanted singer's 34th birthday.
The family's going to remember him at a special event on Sunday. Now, Tom's wife, Kelsey, is with me this morning. Kelsey,
morning to you.
Morning.
Tell me about this weekend. Tell me what you're going to do to celebrate Tom's life.
So what we're doing is we're doing a 5K walk around Petswood, and obviously I just want to raise as much money as I possibly can.
It got me thinking about birthdays. I never really liked
celebrating my birthday. Was he all in for a big birthday bash, or was it just like, oh no, it's just another year?
He was a bit more like, oh, it's another year, but I love, like, a birthday. We always celebrated, always.
Enjoy it, and it's always a joy talking to you, Kelsey.
Thank you so much for having me.
Take care.
Bye. Oh, lots of messages. Max George messaged me. How are you coping, Kels? Well, like, messages like that, I'm like, what? Like, what do you want me to say? How am I coping? Like, how are you coping, Max? Like, obviously he's doing it because he does genuinely care how am I coping, but, yeah, what'd you put? How are you coping? I just put, yeah, all good, babes, just trying to cope the best way I can. That's it, isn't it, really? That's just the answer. Doing these events, trying to raise money, trying to make myself feel better, that can help some other people.
Enjoy.
Ray, what was I calling you last night when you was getting stressed? Baby what? Storm.
I'm gonna do this. Cool. I'm gonna write it.
What are you gonna write in it? How much you love your mum?
3 days.
You love me 3 days? Thanks. Happy Valentine's Day.
Yay!
Oh, hello, my darling. Have you had a good day?
I've been working all day. Oh, Lamshank, you absolute beaut. Oh,
literally, when I met Tom, it was like love at first sight. He was the most unreal person.
I love you, that's why.
We were together for 12, 13 years.
Oh, I mean, look at that picture. How good do I look?
Our relationship was very intense and very hyperactive and very go, go, go.
So go on, do something funny.
Hey! Hey!
And we had this real, like, love for each other that no one else could describe.
Mm-hmm. Huggy, huggy, huggy.
Huggy, huggy, huggy.
Huggy, huggy, huggy.
Great cold hands off my back.
Got makeup on and everything. She's made an effort.
I really made an effort on a Tuesday night.
Like, literally, I loved him so much, and I know that he loved me so much. It was like a bond like no other.
Wow, you're gonna do good writing in that card.
It's a flat, through is air through. I'm not doing this, I'm doing this. Cut it in.
I'm gonna go and see Arj today, who is mine and Tom's really, really good friend. I haven't actually seen him since Tom's funeral, so it'll be nice to catch up with him. And also, I want to talk to him about singing at the 5K walk. Arj has sang at a lot of our events over the years.
Arj, what are you going to sing?
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars.
It'll be really, really nice for Arch to come and sing and be a part of the day. Hello.
Hi.
You all right?
So nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
You. Looking fabulous.
I'm getting there, slowly but surely. How are you?
Yeah, okay. Like, just getting on with it. So hard, because everyone obviously asks me all the time, like, how are you?
Yeah.
It's like, well, as best I can be.
Do you try to give an honest answer? Is it more like a generic answer?
It's a generic answer, because I don't actually know what to say to people, because obviously some days, yeah, I'm like,
I know what you mean. I mean, sometimes it's, obviously, you've got to try and say how you're feeling, what you're going through.
Yeah.
There might be times where you just don't want to...
You say it.
Or you just want to get distracted, like, with other people's stuff, maybe. And I'm sure it's a full-time job with the kids.
Like, this morning she was asking me questions about his birthday and stuff. She was like, oh, it's going to be Uncle Danny's birthday. And I was like, well, actually, it would have been your dad's birthday on Thursday. And then she was like, oh, well, what does that mean?
Is it this Thursday coming
up? Yeah, it would have been his birthday.
You've done so well, Kels. You know, you've got other people to take care of and stuff. Everyone deals with grief in many different ways.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Some people want to be isolated and,
yeah, and some deal with it alone. Like,
some people want lots of support and be around everyone and don't want to talk about it, do want to talk about it, makes them angry, sad, but I suppose it's different for everyone.
Yeah. You know what he was like? What do you want me moping around?
No. We've had so many good times, haven't we?
Yeah, and funny times and memories. When you used to ring us up and ask for advice because you'd always want Tom's like opinion on something.
I used to always ring up Tom and go, do you think I can get Lydia back? No.
No. If you wanted an honest opinion, you'd definitely go to Tom.
Yeah.
You'd always get that.
Always, always. I remember when me and Tom got naked together on
That's what
national television live. And I remember me and Tom got spray tans together before. We was about to get naked in front of millions of people watching at home. We looked at each other and I was like, Tom, am I all right? And he went, and he didn't give me much confidence, that's for sure.
And that's what you think is crazy, that he did the full Monty and then literally got cancer.
I know.
It's crazy.
You couldn't write it, could
but
you?
But you can't write it.
So Sunday it's a celebration for Tom's birthday.
Yeah.
Whatever you need me for, I'm there. Yeah. So I'm going to come, I'll do like a nice little half hour set.
Yeah.
Am I the main act?
You are the main act. I said, like, you've literally sung at every event that we've ever done.
Yeah, I sung at
his stag.
I sung
the
at
baby
your
baby shower.
I sung at the baby shower.
And then our engagement party.
Yeah, they're all like special times, aren't they?
Really special times.
And now that's why it'd be special in some ways for me to sing at this.
Yeah, definitely. That's why obviously I wanted you to do it.
Yeah. No, thanks, Kels. Thanks for always thinking of me. I wouldn't miss it for the world, do you know what I mean?
No, and he would want you there, wouldn't he?
Yeah. Right, Kels. I'll make a move. I promise you, I won't let you down.
You better not let
me. I can't wait. It's going to be a beautiful, special day.
Love you. Singing tune, yeah?
I'll try. Right, I'll see you in a bit.
I'll see you Sunday.
See you, Kels.
Bye. I just don't understand that you're so strong, you're so brave, you're inspirational, because I haven't had a choice in the matter. Like, if I didn't step up and do what I had to do for Tom, then, like, what would I have done? I don't understand. Like, you're so strong, but I have had no other choice. I've had to be strong.
I'm going to meet a group of widowers who are obviously in the title. They are widowed, they're the same as me, they're young. It'll be quite interesting to see where they're at now and what they're doing. Oh, I just think, you know, I always laugh around with people, like my friends, and I always say I'm the hot widow, because really, I sound like a bit big-headed to say that, but it is that word, like widow, like I'm a widower, I'm a widow. It's weird, isn't it? It's like such a weird word, and it seems like a really old word. I completely see why people go to these meetings and would like to talk about it. Me personally, I can talk about it with my friends, and I'm quite open and honest. Obviously, the only thing is my friends can't really relate because they've not been through it. Hi everyone.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Kelsey. Nice to meet you all.
Hello, Kelsey.
Hello. Hello. So, I wanted to come meet you all because I've heard about your group and I just want to know a little bit more about it all.
I'm Hannah.
Hi, Hannah.
Hi. My husband, Cal, died in 2016.
Yeah, so how old were you when that happened? If you don't mind me asking your age.
God, now I need to work it out. 34 I was.
Oh, okay.
And my kids were 7 and 2 at the time. Yeah, he had lymphoma.
Oh, okay, yeah.
That's, yeah.
Your story.
My story. That's nicely narrowed down.
But how do you feel like now?
To be honest, I feel like I've opened a new book.
Amazing.
I've got a degree. I'm waiting to start teacher training.
That's
That's so good.
How about you?
So I'm Emma. Hi, Emma. My husband died of COVID. So he was ill at home for a week. And then he went to ITU. He was in ITU for 3 weeks before he died. But he walked downstairs to the ambulance and then we never saw him again. It didn't seem real. I was told to ring the hospital 2 hours later and they went, oh, he's in ITU, sedated and ventilated. I was like, have you got the right person? So my daughter and I would Skype him every day. And she was so ridiculously pragmatic about the whole thing. Because I'd be like,
how old was she?
She was 10.
Yeah.
And then they rang me the morning to tell me he wasn't going to make it. I was like, what? If I ring anyone, no one can come around. No one can come and give us a cuddle. It was so surreal because no one came in.
My youngest was 5 when his dad died, and he just used to go around introducing himself to people like my dad's did.
Yeah, that's what only dad's my friend.
Do you know any dead people? Yeah. He'd be like, do you know any dead people? My dad's dead. Like,
and I think that's the thing with kids, isn't it? They don't have that filter and that.
Well, it's black and white, black there's and no white. Grey.
We had a son. Alice was diagnosed with breast cancer, which was sort of eminently curable when he was 6 months old, and then we found out in March 2019 that had come back and was terminal. She ended up in a hospice. We actually got married in the hospice.
Aww.
And then she died on the 1st of June. I hate cancer.
Yeah.
It completely transformed her.
The morning after she died, I got up, I can remember doing it at 6:30 in the morning, and I started making a list of everyone I had to tell, like the banks and the insurance companies and all
that. Oh,
that's
just like another...
And it was literally, which that admin is just a nightmare.
Oh, the admin is like, you wouldn't wish that upon anyone.
I won't name the bank. This woman, she looked at Alice's death certificate and our marriage certificate, and as I said, we got married in a hospice, and she said, ooh, you weren't married long, were you? Well, that was my first full-on sort of panic attack, and I just stormed out of the bank. And now I'm almost funny.
Yeah. But what I don't understand is that people die every single day, so surely every single person should be trained with bereavement.
People go, oh, you're so strong, and I hate when people say that. I couldn't do it. You would do it. You have to do it. What are you going to do? Yeah. Just lie on the floor? Like, I've got 3 kids.
About 6 months in, and I was like, the next person that tells me I'm brave or strong, I might punch them. It really annoyed me.
Yeah.
I had somebody ask me if I was over it, and I didn't actually know what they were talking about. And I said, oh, you mean, am I over the death of my husband? No, I'm not. He said, you're a good looking woman, you'll find someone else, just don't worry about it. And I messaged my sister and I went, this, and she went, just take it, someone's called you good looking today. And I went, good point.
Thank you so much.
Nice to meet you. Take care. Bye.
I really enjoyed that. Like, obviously not enjoyed because there's better conversations that I could have, but they completely got like where I was coming from. And like we've been through the same things. They just understood how I felt. And it wasn't like, in a weird way, it wasn't morbid, but all we did actually speak about was death. Yeah, it was actually really refreshing. And I just felt like I could be me and say all the stuff that I actually feel. Like I could speak my truth there. Because sometimes I don't like to say exactly how I feel because I don't want to upset like my friends and family.
Tom's death hasn't just affected me, it's affected my whole entire family. You know, we used to go to my mum and my stepdad's house, well, every Sunday without fail, we'd be there having a roast dinner.
We do a good roast. It's my favourite part of the week, to be honest with you.
Sunday dinner?
Yeah, because I don't have to cook.
Yeah.
But we'd often pop in, like, in the evenings. We go on massive family holidays together. Tom's been such a huge part of my life since I was 19 and a big part of my family's life. And, you know, his death has affected all of us.
Me and Mum are in the Pink Ladies tonight. Look, Mum, we actually are so pinked up. Mum's got a pink bag. I've got my pink bag. She's got a pink dress on. I've got a pink dress on. No? Yeah, for you.
Tell me about it.
Stand. I've got a black T-shirt on as well.
Right, do you want your dinner now?
Come on, dish yourself. It's a bit cold. Didn't expect him to die so quick.
We were shocked when he died.
Yeah, it was a shock.
We've been booked centre parks in December because we thought he was...
Yeah, this year, yeah. We thought we'd come along.
Yeah. It was a shock when he actually went downhill like that. He literally went from not being ill. We came back from Spain and he was really well, wasn't he? Colour in his face, he was walking properly, and then suddenly
just turned. Mm.
He was gone within weeks. Just can't believe that. Yeah.
I mean, she puts on a really brave face, Kelsey, but I mean, she must be dying inside because it's got to be so hard.
Of course, it's really hard.
It's difficult what to say to Kelsey because, you know, I'm quite an emotional person, so if I try and talk to her to give her support, I'm probably going to be the worst person. You lose people along the way, and it makes you, I think it makes you a better person. I think it makes you a stronger person. And the way you are towards people, you know, you only got one shot in life. And we've lost some close family friends.
You've lost your sister, you know, haven't
you?
Mum
and dad. Young age, we've lost Tom.
Yeah, because I think sometimes you actually think he's still here, and then you think, no, he's not. It's like, is he still here? No, he's definitely not. You can't actually believe that he's actually gone.
I just think time's a good healer. Mm. I do believe that. I don't think it's easier. It never gets easy.
I think you learn to deal with it. Yeah,
lot,
I think that
easier.
Person just stays with you, and that's it. They just stay with you forever. Tom will stay with us forever.
I often do dream about Tom, and it's really weird because whenever I dream about him, it's not the Tom that I had for the last like 18 months. It will be the old Tom that will be in my dream. I like dreaming about him. Like, I don't wake up and think, oh, like, I doesn't, it's, I'm happy that he's been in my dream.
Give me a kiss. Love you.
You want to live in that bubble. You don't really want to wake up from them dreams. And then you wake up and you're like, no, he's gone and this is my life now.
What are you doing?
What are you having to say for breakfast? Peggy, you've got Eddie on the go, and then you've got to get changed. I'm doing your lunch. You want a drink? I'll get you a drink. Are you doing
an evening then? Mummy, let's put the stin off. We need to put the stin off.
Today's Tom's birthday. Happy birthday! Sleepy boy. On days like this, I would rather just been with Tom, just hanging out and being with him. Like, you know, having all my family round and hosting a little gathering for him and getting my mum to make her lovely sausage rolls that she bakes. Do you know what I mean? It's hard. Days like today are hard. Who did you play with at school? Get in now. But I'm so lucky because both my kids are absolutely amazing. Like, how they've got me through these dark times, I'm so thankful to have them. They cheer me up, they put a smile on my face, they're both so funny. Like, they are special.
I can jump on the store. I've been to the toy store.
I have a few of my family coming over just to be with me tonight.
Is it all organised for Sunday, is it? Have we got to do anything?
There's loads of jobs.
There's loads of jobs. We need a man in the high-vis. That's what I said.
That's not me. That's Johnny. Johnny can do the high-vis.
What's Johnny got to do? Does he know what he's got to do?
No.
Johnny will love high-vis.
No, we might need some lifting to be done, seriously.
No, Westcombe are giving us the stage, so we need to set the stage up.
Are they dropping it?
No, we've got to go and pick that up. We didn't know that we was obviously going to sell out, but you did say to me,
you just visualised 100 people, didn't you?
I didn't know how many people would come. Danny was like, you're definitely going to sell like 600 tickets. I was like, I don't think we'll sell 600.
You've obviously got those singers, aren't we?
Yeah, I've met Vaj and he said he's going to do it, so that'll be really nice. Do you know what? When I woke up this morning, I was having a bit of a crappy day. And obviously, like, Instagram and that was, like, actually mental. And you just think, oh, it's just too much. So many people, like, messaging me. There's so many pictures, like, of Tom. Like, I've tried to stay off it today and I just did one post.
because that just felt right to do. And I told people the truth, that I had was having a crappy day. I think if I did nothing today, I think I would have really struggled. Off to record Giovanna Fletcher's podcast. So me and Giovanna know each other through the men, really. Like, as in, Tom was in McFly, Tom was in The Wanted, same sort of time, that we're all really good friends. I don't know any questions that she's going to ask. I just know that this will be a really vulnerable podcast for me. It's me! You're right.
Yeah,
you're
okay.
Yeah, I'm good.
Good, good.
Oh,
I'm loving this.
Oh.
Very good.
My loose change. Not that I have a lot of it.
Today's guest is an actress. She's a vlogger. She married the love of her life in 2018, Tom Parker. They went on to have two children, Aurelia and Bodie. It is the amazing Kelsey Parker. Are you a bit sick of the question, how are you at the moment?
Do you, that is the hardest question that people ask you. And obviously people ask me all the time. Yeah. And it's so hard because how do you answer that? Because some days I am okay. Yeah. Some days I'm not okay because I have lost the love of my life. So, you know, that question's always going to be hard for me. Because when will I ever be okay?
And we're talking about death and talking to children about death. And what I found interesting is that listening to you talk about it, you very much use the word dead.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You didn't use, you know, imagery that might be confusing to them.
I did speak to someone as well. I did seek advice. And even, because what was hard is obviously when Tom went into the hospice, I was then there with him at the hospice. So Aurelia was getting really upset that, like, she wasn't seeing me.
Yeah.
And I had to say to her, like, the day that he was dying and I knew he was going to die, I said that, oh, God, it's so sad to say, that I'm going to go to the hospital today to make sure that the angels come and take Daddy because Daddy's going to die. Oh, it's so horrible to say. But I was really honest because she needed to know. And she was okay with that. When I told her that angels are taking her dad today, she was like, oh, okay. And then off she skipped. Like, it was just... And then the next day I said, Daddy's dead and he's not coming back. And that's it. What else could I say to her?
I know that you two laid in bed together.
Yeah, and I just said to him, it's okay. It's okay for you to go. If you need to go... Wait for Tishy. I said, if you need to go, you can go now. Like, I know that you've done everything you can possibly do, and if it's your time, it's your time. And then we had a really nice night together, and that was a really hard, obviously, conversation to have.
Especially after you have both united, you know, you've united in the whole way through.
It's made me not scared to die again. Like, I'm not...
Really?
Yeah. Watching Tom die, I'm not scared to die. If I could have a death like him, I'd be really happy.
I mean, I love the positivity that you have brought. You know, just a massive thank you for everything that you're doing in being so open.
It's been so nice to sit down and chat. No, it has been great. But I found podcasts really hard. I feel really exposed in a podcast. Because I just feel like that with this experience, you know, people are judging me. Like, people are judging me, aren't they? Not judging me in a bad way, but they're looking onto me thinking, how am I coping with stuff?
Do you feel like that's because you feel like people might think there's a right way to grieve?
Yeah, but there's no right way to grieve.
No. Even if we experience things that are similar, our take on it's always going to be different. So you just have to keep talking in a way that's true
right
to you.
To me. Some people do actually cross the street not to talk to me as well.
They're a rubbish nation at talking about death.
We are. Whatever happens with my life is always going to be a massive part of it.
Well, that's what the children are.
Yeah.
The children are him continuing in so many ways. What do you reckon you'd make of them having southern accents, though?
I would have hated it.
The podcast recording was emotional, as expected. I think it's really hard to even speculate over how Kelsey is doing, you know, in terms of losing Tom, of having little kids as well. And I do think that when you are in that situation and you do have little ones, it is a case of life continues, that you have to get out of bed for them. And in many ways, they are a complete and utter blessing. But I think when you do have kids, the thought of being in that situation, I think it's beyond any of us can ever imagine.
I feel like she just got so much out of me. And I did think that was going to be the case. And it was very emotional, and I did cry. And I find that hard crying. But I did it, and I felt like that was really good for me to actually do that.
Oh, would you like a cup of tea, dear?
Yes, please. Yeah, I love a cup of tea this time of day.
Great. I was a little bit worried about Kelsey because when Tom really took ill, she took to her bed. Because obviously, by that time, we realised that he was going to die. I thought, oh my God, is she going to be able to cope with this?
Obviously, what she was trying to do was not, she didn't want to do it.
Yeah, she didn't want to go up there and she knew he was going to die. And she thought, can I actually have the strength to sit and watch him die here? So she took to her bed. So I said to her, you need to go up the hospital and see Tom. And she said, I'm going. And after that, yeah, she just like had an inner strength and she coped with it,
didn't she?
Just go with me on this, but...
Do you know what? I'm actually not worried about showing the kids emotion because I think that's life. So if I am upset, I will show them I'm upset and why I will explain to them why I'm upset as well. So there's only been like the odd morning that I've actually cried with the kids being around. And Aurelia can pick up on that straight away. She's like, Mum, why are you crying? And I say, because I'm sad, because we've lost Daddy. I'm very honest with them. Today's finally the day of Tom's birthday walk and I'm so excited to spend the day with my friends and family and everyone that's going to turn out for it. I'm hoping it will be a great day and a huge success and something that I can do every year. I feel like I'm prepared and everything's ready and I'm good to go. Hopefully. Hello.
Put your head up. Oh, I love it.
Yeah, and it's just off my face, isn't it, now?
Yeah.
And it's like celebration.
Yeah. I love it.
Love it. Gemma's actually my longest friend. Me and Gemma have been best friends since we were 5.
What are we doing with your makeup today?
Do what you think. Nice lip, nice face.
Bronzed.
Yeah. The dinosaurs and the bouncy castle have had to swap positions, Lise.
Wow, the dramas. How are you feeling about today?
I'm excited. I just think it's nice for everyone to come and celebrate as well. Again, like, celebrate him.
Tom would love it.
He would absolutely have loved today. If he was around now and I was putting on an event, he would turn up and be like, oh, this is amazing, but he would have done, like, no work towards it anyway, so... Tom would have, like, sat back and done nothing and then turned up on the day and owned the day and been like, oh, yeah, I put this amazing event on. He would have been in charge of all the music, he would have been in charge of all the acts, the artists. So he would have had a part to play, but I very much doubt that he would have done a 5K walk. Just bring all the stuff to here, the banner and the tables, all to the memorial gardens. Yeah, do you want a gazebo, Jen? Because Johnny's got one. Do you want a gazebo?
If you've got
yeah, if you've got one, that's amazing. Jenny would like that. Thank you. Love you so much. I'll see you soon. You are the best stepdad ever. I'm having a bench put in the memorial garden.
You've got to polish it up.
Because I just think it's somewhere lovely where people can go and sit and think about Tom. And it'll be lovely for my kids to have it so close to home.
Nice to see
Queens
it all come together.
I can't wait for it to actually just start and have people in
here.
Oh, look, Kelsey's here.
Welcome
the
home.
Other Kelsey. She's ready. She can't wait to get her high vis on, can you?
Who's wearing the high vis today?
So I've had t-shirts made, which are really lovely, and they've got a really nice picture of Tom on the front of them. For me, it's weird to keep looking at pictures of him and seeing him because I just think it's just a constant reminder of he's not actually here with me.
It's
sad, but I think doing things like this, it keeps the momentum going of his life. So he'd find things like this absolutely hilarious. Like, I was up here last night putting that sign up, and you think, like, he would be standing absolutely cracking up, like, watching me up there. So I think he'd would have enjoyed today, but obviously he's up there watching instead. So yeah, it's nice. I think everyone will enjoy every moment of today. Just got to get past the ball first.
Let's do it! 3, 2, 1, let's go!
The sun goes down, the stars come out, and all that comes is here and now.
I've come down from Bolton today to join the walk, Kelsey's walk. Been amazing, a very successful day. I think Tom would have been very happy with it. The topsy-turvy situation that it is, you know, one minute you can be okay, having a great time, and the next minute it can be in floods of tears. And I think that's the most upsetting part. It just feels so surreal that you almost wake up and think it can't be true that it's really happened. It just feels important that we're part of the celebration of Tom's birthday, really, to carry on his legacy.
You cast a spell on me, you hit me like the sky fell on me, and I decided you look well, well on me. So let's go somewhere no one else can see you and me. Turn the lights out now.
Today is such a great turnout. There's over 600 people here and it is buzzing, and the event is just going amazing.
I'm glad you came. I'm glad you came.
Oh my goodness, what have you had done to your face? Oh my goodness! Look at you. Give me a kiss.
I just want to say, this has been such a hard time for me, but you guys coming out, it means everything to me and my family. Thank you so much. And just thank you, Tom, for letting the sun shine today. Right, over to Arch, here we go.
Right, well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. What an honour it is to be here with you lovely lot today. Sorry I missed the walk. I timed it just to perfection.
Right, let's do this.
Girls, come up here and join me on stage. Just have a bit of fun.
You're just too good to be true. I can't take my eyes off of you. I love you, baby.
Honestly, couldn't have gone any better. Today was kind of extra special for me, because not only have I done this for you, but I also feel like I've, you know, done something for Tom and Tom's honour and stuff, and that's why it was so meant a lot to me.
He would be so impressed, like I could just actually hear his voice now of what he'd be saying about this event, because he loved me putting on any shows or anything like that, so he would actually love this. He would have loved this event, and he probably is here now with us. I don't know if there'll necessarily be like an emotional come down, but I don't know, because on this journey of grief I never know what's actually around the corner for me. I don't know how I'm gonna feel. Today I feel like elated and so proud of myself that I've actually managed to do this. See you later. Bye everyone. Bye.
It was so good. We raised over £13,000 to alternative brain tumour charities. And I just think Tom would be so proud that for everything that I'm doing, and I'm making a difference and I'm helping other people.
Night, Tom.
It's that thing that people feel bad, like, sorry for us, are we ready for therapy?
It's not like that at all.
Me and Rio always say, people don't understand because they haven't been through it.
I don't want this to define me either, like Kelsey Parker, the widow.
I know it's a cliche phrase, but there is something about underestimating your children.
Everyone was quiet when I came in the room.
If you or anyone you know is affected by the issues raised in this show, then please visit itv.com/advice, where you will find support and further information about bereavement.